coast to coast, direct from Austin. You're listening to the Alex Jones Broadcasting Network.
Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Well, the Health and Human Services Secretary has come out and said that there may be other cases in the United States. And, of course, he went on to say and repeat that we need to leave the borders open and have unlimited flights from West Africa into the U.S. to stop it, saying that aid workers had to be able to get over there and back when everyone knows there's international aid relief missions from the U.N., NATO, AFRICOM, the United States military, and that most of the aid workers are not flying in and out via aircraft. And that's why the French and the British and countless others a month and a half ago banned flights out of the Ebola-struck countries. And the countries neighboring it, neighboring the other nations that have been struck by Ebola, the UN estimating millions will have it by December, they are controlling their borders and shutting them down and quarantining people, but not the United States. It is a politically correct religious sacrament. Because you cannot ever send the message that anyone could ever raise a hand to block a fist. The cardinal rule of the collectivists and the parasites is never, never, ever, ever, ever allow anyone to defend themselves unless they work for the state or the system. The cardinal rule of a criminal system is no one is allowed to defend themselves from crime, period, or disease or any threat. They want pure, servile, domesticated, deaf, dumb, and blind vassals who can't even communicate or have a costume party because it's racist. Where scientific words are thought crimes. Where if you deny that carbon dioxide is causing global warming, a proven fact that it's a total fraud, then you should be arrested. And I agree with Michael Savage. I mean, obviously they're wanting it to come in, they're wanting it to spread on one end to create a crisis as a political diversion from Syria and Turkey, basically aiding Al-Qaeda and attacks on the Kurds, and just huge news with what's happening with Russia and Obama acting with executive orders on the future of the internet and on the future of carbon taxes and the future of the military and the future of Obamacare and the future of so many other things. All we're focused on is Ebola because it is a serious issue, but still distractionary overall from the larger globalist offensive that is taking place. And the cardinal rule is we can't ever imagine that having privacy protects you or closing your door at night is a good thing or having a border is a good thing. Only government buildings have fences and guards. You don't have a right to own a gun and protect yourself, they say. It's a privilege. Just like traveling is not a privilege, but they told all their mindless minions that, so they quack it at you at the illegal checkpoints and the rest of it. Inside the country, it is a right. And if you're a citizen, it's a right to come and go. Notice the CDC says, oh, we can't stop anybody from coming and going, including people that aren't citizens, like the gentleman that just died from Ebola. Because right now, the borders of the U.S. are completely gone. The country is wide open. We're going to break it all down today. He was on with us a few weeks ago, and before he goes back to South America, I wanted to get him back on. He's the author of Totally Incorrect, Conversations with Doug Kasan. I enjoyed the interview. I thought we'd have him back on to take phone calls and also talk about political incorrectness, how we counter the Marxist-Leninist, I mean, that's what it is. That's not rhetoric. Mind control of where they're now saying ban men and women kissing, that it's racist. Everything's fine. The government loves you. 2 + 2 equals whatever the government says, and raising the debt limit doesn't raise the debt limit. You didn't build your business, and everything is awesome when you're part of a team. In fact, can we cue that up? Because that's basically the CDC said, run for the hills, we're all dead, give us more funding. Oh my God, biggest Ebola outbreak in history, which it was, taking place in Africa. It gestates, it incubates for 21 days instead of 3, meaning it can spread a lot longer. This is so incredibly dangerous. Oh, it could collapse Africa, it could kill millions. And then as soon as it shows up here, well, first, oh, it can't show up here. It's very unlikely. Or, oh, it's no big deal. It's here. And we don't need to clean anything up. And then now they've taken a sheriff's deputy to the hospital that they made go into the building. Why were they sending sheriff's deputies and police into this person's apartment? Why didn't they have regular hazmat teams there once they knew the guy had Ebola? They waited 3-4 days. Why didn't they quarantine the family? All the defaults are turned off. Let me just give the police a little news flash here. I'm sure you already know this. The default is you don't go in to a house with smallpox or Ebola. A, you're just going to catch it and spread it. B, it's not your job. It's the health department's job and the state health department's job, and the CDC does have the prerogative over it on the borders and has hogged all the public funding, and so it is their job de facto. But as usual, they wouldn't help in Katrina. FEMA blocked everybody for at least 8 days, blocked all the local counties and cities and the Texas fire departments and police departments that came that could have turned the power back on and fixed everything. But no, you can't send the message that the states or the counties or other states working together could fix things. So they had to cut the police communication lines. Remember that? It came out on CBS News. We actually had the, what was his name, Richard, the New Orleans parish sheriff on. We had him on. They were ordered to stand down. And he sat there for 4 days while his mother was in several feet of water up to the gurney she was on in a nursing home in New Orleans. And he followed orders and didn't go and get his mama, and his mama died. Let me just give everybody a little news flash here. If the feds are blockading a city just because of water and won't let people and won't let local departments get old people out of a nursing home or a hospital, and my mother's in there or my family's in there, I'm coming to get them. And that's not shooting my mouth off. I've got my life force. I've got my common sense. I remember watching that sheriff get up on TV and break down crying about how they wouldn't let him go get his mama. 30 years ago, the sheriffs would laugh at the FBI and FEMA, telling them they didn't have jurisdiction in their own county. Does everybody? And the reason I raise this now is it's the same thing with Ebola and political correctness and all the rest of it. They won't control our borders, and they won't stop the flights, even though everybody else is, from West Africa and countries that have literally collapsed. The countries right next door to Liberia and Sierra Leone and all the other 4 or 5 countries that have it, they have machine gun nests set up. Third world African dictators have more common sense, to quote Michael Savage here yesterday, than our government. But see, it's not common sense. Our government knows what it's doing. It is a religion to have open borders under globalism. And you can only have super region responses, super border responses from northern Guatemala up to Alaska in all the New World Order, North American Union, EU, Asian Pacific Trade Partnership documents. You can't have nations or cities or states or counties that are allowed to respond. You only can have global government respond. And so when they order the stand downs, all over the world this is done. Then people say something must be done. Give more funding to the multinational, multi-regional NATO save us. UN save us. Everything is awesome. Here comes the big central planners. They know what to do. So what we're doing is decoding.